And we saved the most disgusting, the most horrible thing of all for last. What am I describing? Allegedly, it can cause birds to fall dead from the sky, and it's banned by airlines, but it's quite good on toast. Well, you're... Oh, no! No wonder you've not been getting points, Chris.
Oh, that's typical.
Yes, that's unfair. Chris, you can answer.
What was the question?
Is it gentleman's relish?
No. I have some here. I have a can of it. But... and this is a genuine can of it.
It's a caviar.
No.
Oh, this is something rotten, isn't it?
Yeah.
Scandinavian rotten food.
It's Scandinavian rotten fish.
Oh, yeah, exactly. They had it on Midsummer's Night, don't they? I've always wanted to try that.
Surströmming. I've actually been told, and you may say, oh, go on, Stephen, that I cannot open this, that if I did, the audience, probably the audience at home would go away. It is apparently so disgusting that it would never leave the studio. And I think we'd be sued by the studio for
opening it. By the Graham Norton show.
It is, yeah, by the Graham Norton show. It's called Surströmming. It's herring. What happens is you put the herring in a barrel, first of all, in a wooden barrel, with about half the amount of salt you need to cure it. So it's not cured. Instead of being cured, it ferments. In other words, it putrefies. And then after it's been like that for a month or so, you then put it in a can. But the can is designed, as you can tell, to swell up slightly. So it's continuing to ferment. It's still...
They buckle, don't they?
They buckle. And it is absolutely, unbelievably disgusting, the smell. There is nothing, apparently, as revolting, really, on the face of the...
A friend of mine lives in Sweden. He said that, you know, that is something you have to be Swedish to eat.
Yeah, indeed. They consider it a delicacy. Often what they do is they open the can underwater, because the way to eat it anyway is to rinse it and then cover it in sort of onions, which helps with the smell a bit, and then drink it
It's
down.
Got a best before date.
It is a bit late. I'm going to move this away.
Best because, before we canned it.
Yeah. Apparently, in the 16th century, there were... you can have a look at the can if you like, but please don't open it. There were Swedish sailors... No, who ran out of salt, and they had this rotting fish, and they found some Finnish islanders that they sold it to, thinking that, you know, they're idiot foresters and who know no better. And then a year later, they came back and they met these same people, and they said, can we have some more of this rotten fish, please? So they thought, oh, maybe it's good. So they tried it themselves, and apparently it is tasty, even though it smells...
It's a can.
...beyond anything. Yeah, I'm glad to say the can is holding up. So, there you are. Surströmming Baltic herring fermented in cans with foul-smelling and explosive but allegedly delicious results. And so, we...